together, that is sports and women empowerment. The women grandmaster, the international master, we have with us Bhakti Kulkarni. Hi Bhakti, welcome to our show.
Hope you and your family
is doing well.
Yes, by God's grace, we are keeping well. Thank you so much. And first of all, I would like to wish all my fellow Goans a very happy Goa Statehood Day.
Thank you. This pandemic has changed our daily life and we have welcomed the new normals. Bhakti, we would like to know, what is the new normal for you?
It's been a terrible year, I would say. But I think being a chess player, and we had this indoor game, I think we are kind of lucky since we can still train online and still play all the online tournaments and sit at home and prepare. But yeah, definitely I'm missing on the board tournaments where I usually used to travel almost for 22 tournaments a year. So it's really difficult times. But yeah, thanks to my Chess Federation, India Chess Federation and World Chess Federation, they have been continuously organizing many online chess events. And you must be knowing, last year we were very fortunate to have participated in the online Olympiads. And India had won its first gold medal along with Russia in the online Olympiad. And it was the first gold medal for India. And I'm super happy to share that I was one of the team members of the Indian team. And since it was online games, you won't believe, but all my teammates were sitting in different places. For example, I was sitting in Goa and playing. My teammates Vishwanathan Anand, who is the world champion, he was playing from Chennai, and other teammates like Hari Krishna, he was playing from Prague, Czech Republic. So it was kind of convenient for chess players to play online tournaments.
So during this time, you must be really missing the traveling part from one state to another and one nation to another.
Really missing. Like this is like a blessing in disguise, I would say, because I never got time to spend with my family since last almost 17-18 years. Right now, by God's grace, I was not having any tournaments since last February, so I could stay safely at my place. But yeah, definitely I'm missing my online on-the-board tournaments. And there is a good news I would like to share with you all. Last year, I think in 2019, I was the national champion. And due to pandemic, we could not have our world championships on the board. So now the world championships are going to be held from 9th of July in Russia. And that's going to be my first on the board tournament. So I'm really looking forward to play and to travel to Russia.
Okay, we are wishing you all the best for that.
Now
as we don't have an option of virtual and physical, but as a sports person, what do you prefer, a virtual or a physical game?
Definitely physical.
Okay. Yeah, any hurdles are faced in virtual games, such as network or something else?
Yeah, there were many hurdles even during my online Olympiads where I was playing my games, and many times because of rain or some connectivity issues, I had to wait for some 5-10 minutes during the game because of some electricity issue and internet issues. So it's definitely any time I would prefer on the board tournaments.
Okay, life is like a chess game and you don't want to waste a single move. During this pandemic, have you missed out any move?
Never. Actually, during this pandemic, I was mainly focusing on keeping myself very positive, and I was regularly doing all these good things like exercising, meditating, pranayama, doing all kind of things which will keep me motivated, because I know someday it's going to end and that time I have to be completely ready to face my opponents, face my tournaments. So yeah, it was new normal, but it was good that I was at home. But I really wish that all this pandemic ends soon and everyone, you know, feel safer soon.
Okay. So, I want to know, Bhakti, what is your state of mind today?
Today, I am actually completely focused on my world championship because I have hardly 1 month. So I'm not able to think anything about anything else right now. I'm totally into training and preparing self-practice and playing online events. So, right now, I'm keeping myself very busy.
Bhakti, it is not very easy for a person who has been traveling and moving out and having a very busy schedule, like attending various kind of tournaments. How do you feel, like, you know, it's like you are playing at home virtually, but you are like sitting back at home. How do you feel, and what is the support that you are getting from your family?
Yeah, my family has played a big role in supporting me, in motivating me, also my coaches and my friends. I think, yeah, definitely I am missing my traveling, but I am trying to make use of this extra 1 or 2 years of this span to improve myself on various areas, not just in chess, but being a good person. I've started reading a lot of books, self-help books, and I was trying to be more creative in this period, and definitely it's helping me to stay positive in such difficult times.
Okay. Every chess master was once a beginner. So any message to the beginners who are missing their coaching, their training, and you know, they just can't cope up the way you are coping up virtually. So any message for them?
I think first of all, if you want to be in some field and if you want to really excel there, I think this message would be for both parents and kids, that please spend at least 5 to 6 years proper training, proper preparing, and only then expect about the results. So I would think, just don't think about results and get disheartened, because many times I've seen nowadays kids don't have patience. So if they play one tournament, if they lose one game, that's over. They feel like, oh my God, I don't want this tournament or this sport anymore. But I think it's important to first of all find out what passion your kids are having, and accordingly take actions. And then being a parent, you have to motivate your kids to, you know, take up whatever they like, but make sure he or she works hard.
Okay. Bhakti, would you like to share any of your experience wherein you faced that trauma kind of thing? I lost a tournament and I don't know now how it will happen, how I will go ahead. Have you ever experienced that kind of a situation?
Oh my God, being a player, being a sports person, I have experienced it many times. But I would like to share few incidents. Like, I was playing in one of the nationals, in women nationals in 2017. It was happening in Mysore, and in the first round itself, I had lost to a lower rated, and losing first round against a lower rated, it's like very bad. But I tried to, you know, motivate myself, and okay, it was a Swiss event. That means everyone has to play 11 rounds against everybody. So for me, I thought that, okay, just one game is lost, I still have 10 more rounds. So that is what I think chess teaches us. Whatever, I mean, even if you lose one game, it's okay. We have to move on. We have to be positive. We have to be optimistic about what future is going to be, and just enjoy the present. So I was really working hard even after losing the first round, and I managed to win the remaining, I think, 9.5 out of 10, and I won the championship. So it was a turning point, I would say, because it becomes very difficult if you lose the first round where you are expected to win the tournament. So I didn't allow the loss to go into my head. Instead, I took it as a challenge, and I wanted to, you know, make sure that this loss doesn't make me feel bad, and instead I took it in a positive way.
Okay. Bhakti, this was about sports. Now, speaking of women empowerment, Bhakti, as a woman, did you face any hurdle? You were traveling, or you had to go for practice, coaching. As a woman, have you ever faced any kind of hurdle in your match or in your profession?
As a woman, I think it was very difficult in the initial times, because in Goa, there were hardly few women players, few girl players who used to play. So I was, I think, the first girl who won all the age group tournaments, I mean, including men and women tournaments. So it was kind of a good thing that I wanted to show an example where you can actually fight hard. If you are working hard, you can win whatever, you can achieve your dreams. So, and in that way, when I started playing tournaments, I was very young at that time. I started at the age of 4. So at that time, it was difficult for me to travel alone. So that was one of the important hurdles. So I always had to travel along with some friends or my family members. But then since I got the sponsorship from Mr. Srinivas Dempo and Dempo Groups, it was very easy for me to travel. And later on, still it's a bit difficult to travel alone abroad because now I don't have any sponsorship. But yeah, I think main thing for the sports person in chess field is that women players are not having enough sponsorship, enough job opportunities, and especially in the field of chess. So I think something should have happened because last year I had been the gold medalist in Olympiad and Asian teams. So I feel at least within 1 or 2 years, they should start giving some jobs opportunities to women players to encourage them to take up chess.
Okay, any message to a woman player who maybe a small little girl who's taking coaching of chess, or some woman who had to hold back because of the various reasons, any message to them?
Yeah, definitely. So first of all, if you want to pursue any career in whichever field, make yourself available for at least 10 years. Like, you have to be ready to practice, to prepare hard for at least 10 years. So this thing, even parents should take note of. And don't get disheartened if you lose 1 or 2 tournaments or if you lose 1 or 2 years. Because from every mistake, you have to learn. You have to keep that attitude to learn from all your mistakes and try to improve. And yeah, definitely try to do something new. Like, don't try to do what other people are doing. If you are good at doing some YouTube things, then you have to do that. Because right now, even I was only focused on playing tournaments, but recently I started training online to other students. So that gives me different perspective. Like, when we try to teach others, I felt that it gives me more knowledge, because first of all, I have to learn all those things in order to give that knowledge to my students. So that has helped me really. So if you are not into a player kind of attitude, then at least you have to learn the things and try to be a trainer. I mean, do something creative.
Okay, Bhakti, I would also like to know, what are your future plans? Where are we looking, Bhakti Kulkarni, in next couple of years?
Okay. So when I started playing chess, my first dream was to become national champion, then women's grandmaster. And so when I achieved those titles, now my aim is to become a world champion, and I'm really working hard towards it. But I think it would be really great if job opportunities are there for women players, because it's very difficult. Like, many players after getting married, they just cannot continue their chess or any other field. So it would be really great if something happens in a positive way.
Okay.
And yeah, I would like to have my own chess academy where I could share my knowledge with youngsters.
We're wishing you all the best for that.
Thank you so
Bhakti,
much.
As a woman, did you get any hurdles from your family? I know I'm asking you a bit personal question, but yes.
No, I was very lucky, I would say. I was very lucky because my dad, he loves chess a lot. And in his college days, he used to play chess, but because of some financial issues, he could not pursue. But then when I was around 2 and a half, he started teaching me all the basics, and my father, my mom, they both really helped me. They used to travel with me to most of the tournaments. So I was very fortunate, and even my school teachers, my school, my Mahilan, I studied in Mahilan Uttan school. So all my teachers, headmistress, everyone used to really motivate me. Even, you won't believe, when I was in 5th standard to 10th standard, all these 6 years, I used to go to school at around 10:30 if there are many important tournaments coming up. So all these exemptions were given to me. So I am really fortunate and grateful to all of them.
Okay, so on this statehood day, we were reading the state of minds, and I want you to, as a sportsperson, as a woman, as a identity of Goa, I want you to give a message to every Goan on this statehood day.
Okay, first of all, considering the COVID pandemic, I have to say, please stay at home, everyone. Don't go out unless it's necessary, and try to learn chess. I mean, there are so many things you can do at home. This last year has completely changed me, because I got I got to learn lot many things apart from chess, like meditation and many different things. So please try to learn, try to be a student always in life, and whatever you are doing, do it with 100%, give your best, and work really hard and have goals. Like what I do usually, I try to plan my schedule, my goals. I make a list of my goals, whatever I want to achieve, and I try to give a date, a deadline to achieve it. So something like that, which keeps you motivated throughout. So try to do something like this and be fit. Yeah, I mean, many people ask me, being a chess player, you don't have to do exercise. But no, it's completely wrong. I mean, we have to sit at the board for almost 7 to 8 hours during the tournament. So it's important, not just for me, but for everyone to be physically and emotionally and mentally fit. So do something for your mental peacefulness and for your physical fitness.
Okay, so this was the International Master and Women Grandmaster Bhakti Kulkarni with us on the Statehood Day. He was wishing all the Goans a happy Statehood Day.
Thank you so much for having me here.
Thank you.
And wishing all of you a very happy Statehood Day.